The rise of the web has taken JavaScript places it was never conceived to be. Now, it has become one of the most important languages in today's world. It was actually built in order to create beautifully designed websites. Now, along with beautifully designed websites, it is also important to authenticate the user in JavaScript. Hi everyone, this is Shantini from Edureka, and in today's session, we will see how validation is done in JavaScript. Now, before we begin the session, let's have a look at today's agenda. So at first, we will discuss what is JavaScript, and then we will have a look at the different JavaScript functions. Moving on, we will have a look at one such function that will be used to validate or authenticate a user using JavaScript. And finally, I will show you how form validation is done in JavaScript with the help of an example. Now, before we get started with the session, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you can continue watching such videos. Now let's get started. So what is JavaScript? Now JavaScript is basically a high-level interpreted programming language that is used to make the web pages more interactive. It is indeed a very powerful client-side scripting language which makes your web page more lively and interactive. Now, it is a programming language that helps you to implement a complex and beautiful design on web pages. So, if you want your web page to look alive and do a lot more than just gawk at you, JavaScript is a must. Now, this language is used to create beautiful web pages and applications, and also used in smartwatches. Not just that, it is also used to make games and also build different websites such as Google, Facebook, Netflix, Amazon, etc. Now let's move ahead and talk about the JavaScript functions. So what are the JavaScript functions? The fundamental building blocks in JavaScript are known as the functions. So it is basically a set of statements that performs a task or calculates a value. Now in order to use a function, it should be defined somewhere in the scope from which you wish to call it. Now basically a function definition consists of the function keyword followed by the name of the function, a list of parameters to the function enclosed in parentheses and separated by commas, the JavaScript statements that define the function enclosed in curly brackets. You can also see the syntax for a function where you just have to type a function name and provide your parameter and then type your code that is to be executed. Now there are different functions that you can use to perform any action in JavaScript. In a similar way, you can use a function to validate or authenticate any particular user. So let's move ahead and see what is validation. Now validation is basically a method to authenticate the user. So JavaScript provides the facility to validate the form on the client side, so data processing will be faster than server-side validation. Now it is preferred by most of the web developers. Through JavaScript, we can validate name, password, email, date, mobile numbers, and more fields. Now, basically, a client-side validation prevents the client from knowing whether the form is okay before reloading a page, whereas server-side validation is important due to the fact that client-side validation can be completely bypassed by turning off JavaScript. So now that you know the different fields on which you can perform the validation, let's move ahead and take an example and see how validation works in JavaScript. Now, in today's session, we will take the example of form validation in JavaScript. So let's see how the code works. So in today's session, we will see how we can perform form validation in JavaScript. So let's see what will be the basic code. So here we will start with the HTML tag and then move on and we have our head tag. And then the title tag, and then we will add our script tag. Now inside script, we will have our type, that is the script type is equals to text slash JavaScript. Now here you can add your code, and we will see that later on. Here we are closing the script tag and the title and the head. Now after that, we will begin with our body tag. So here I'll type the body tag. Now inside our body tag, we will put the form. So we are using a form in order to check the validation. So here I'll add a form, that is the form tag. And now we will specify certain action inside our form. So in our form, we will have a submit button. So here I'll write inside our form tag on submit equals to return validate. So validate is our HTML source code, and once we run this code, it should return the validate function. Now here we will add the action to our form. So for our action, we will link it to our text file, which is text.html. Now what is this text file? So here I have created another basic text file which just has one heading tag, that is welcome to Edureka. So what happens when we have created the form, and once we submit the name, password, and finally authenticate the user and click on the submit button, it redirects to a different page. Now it will be redirected to this particular page, and inside this page we have just given one heading, that is welcome to Edureka. It's just one basic example. You can design it the way you want to. Here I'm just showing you what happens when you redirect or click the submit button in your validate.html program. So once we have closed the head tag, now we will begin with our body tag. Now inside this body form, we will create our form. So here we will have a form tag, and I'll just give the name of my form as my form and assign the method as post, and also specify the action here. So my action will be equal to the text.html file. Now what is this text.html file? So I have created one text.html file where I have just given one h1 tag which says welcome to Edureka. So what happens once we have created our form and validated our username and password? So once we click on the submit button in our form, it is redirected to a different page. So the text.html is the page where it will be redirected to. Now once we click on the submit button, it will go to another page where it will show the heading as welcome to Edureka. Now this is a very basic example. You can also add different types of tags and also add different other features in this page itself. Now going back to our code, so I'll type on submit equals to return validate. So on submit will give the return validate form. Now here basically our validation will be returned on a click. That is when we click on the submit button. So it will validate the user and then take us to our text.html and redirect it to the different page. Next up, I will specify the fields for my form. So the first field would be name. And inside name, I will have the input tag. So here I'll just write input type is equals to text. So our input type for the name would be text. And the name, I'll specify it as name itself. Now the next field would be the password field. So I'll just copy this particular line and put it in the next one and just change the name field as password. Also here the type will be password, because once we type the password, it should not be visible. So when we give the type as password, it would be shown as dots or stars. Now I'll change the name to password as well. Now once this is done, we will give another input type, which is for our submit button. So here the type will be submit and the value will be specified as register. So now with this, we have created our form type where we will have our name and password fields. And once we enter the name and the password, we will have another register button to click on that will redirect us to a different page. Now once this is done, when we run this code, you will see this particular web page that comes as our output. So you have seen that we have given the fields as name, password, and also we have a register button. So here you can enter the name and here you can enter the password, and once you have entered the name and password, you can register, and then the page will be redirected to our text.html page. Now here we have created a very basic form, but we also want to add certain conditions that will be included while adding the name and the password. Suppose I want that whenever we leave the field blank, any of the fields such as name or password, if either of the fields are left blank, it'll give a pop-up or an alert message saying that you cannot leave the fields blank. Or for password, I can give a condition such as it should be 6 characters long. And if we type anything less than 6 characters, it will still give an alert pop message. Now this will be added inside our script tag. So now let me just type inside my script tag and validate this particular function. So here we will be creating our function. So here we will just type function and then we will give a name to it. Suppose I'm giving the name of my function as validate form. So exactly here we have returned the validate form. So this is basically the name of our function. So I'll just close this and start the curly braces. Now inside our function, we will define the name. So for that, we will just write var name equals to document.myForm.name.value. Now this one is for the first field, that is our name field. Here I'm creating a variable which is our name, and inside that I'm just giving the value for this particular variable. Now this is our first field. In the same way, we have to create our second field for password. So I'll just copy this one and go to the next line and paste. And here I'll just change the name to password. And for my document type, this will also be changed into password.value. Now once I have given the names and once my function is also specified, now it's time to provide the conditions. So I'll provide the condition as if name equal equal null or name equal equal blank spaces. So basically, if you just give blank spaces and try to register, it'll still show you the alert message or the pop-up that will say that you can't leave it blank. So now this is my condition, and inside this condition, I'll give the alert message, which is name can't be blank. So I'm giving this error message as name can't be blank. So this is my first condition. So in this case, it'll return false. So here I'm giving the condition that if my name is null or blank spaces, it'll give the alert as name can't be blank and return false. Now this was my if condition. Next I will add my else if condition. Now for the else if condition is for the password. So suppose I want my password to be more than 6 characters long. So I'll give the condition as else if password.length less than 6. So once it identifies that the length of the password is less than 6, it'll give this particular alert. So I can just write that password must be at least 6 characters long. So I'll just write password must be at least 6 characters long. Now in case our password is less than 6 characters, it'll give us this particular alert and return false. So now here we have added our if-else-if conditions. So in this case, you cannot leave your name as blank or your password as blank or anything less than 6 characters. So now let's save this code and let's go back to our output. So this is our form validation. So now let's see how it works here. So now I've left my name and my password field both blank. Now let's see what happens when I click on the register button. So now as soon as I click on the register button, you can see that the pop-up has appeared here. It says name can't be blank. So I had given the alert message as name can't be blank. So this is exactly what it is showing. So here the name field is left blank. So now let's just type a name here. So let me just write Edureka. And now let me try registering here. So now again, once I register, it shows that password must be at least 6 characters long, because I've left the password field blank here as well. So now let me just type the password as 1234 and see what happens. So now once I register, now this shows me the pop-up as password must be at least 6 characters long. It is still not redirecting to the different page because both the conditions must be satisfied. First of all, both your fields should be filled with values. The first one should have a name and the second one has the condition where the password must be at least 6 characters long. So now let me just add 56 and now let me try and register and see what happens. So now we have both our fields completed here and we also have our password length as 6. So now when I click on register button, you can see that it has been redirected to my text.html file. So in my text.html file, I had given the head tag as welcome to Edureka. So you can see that as soon as both the conditions have been satisfied, I am redirected to another page where I get to see my head tag. So now this was just a very simple example of how you can authenticate a user with the help of validating the name and password. So it can be used for any type of form, such as if you have to submit a form or register somewhere. This is how it works. Not just that, we can also perform validation on our mobile numbers, email IDs, passwords, and many more fields. It depends on the type of form that you are creating. Now, validation helps you to authenticate a user so that the communication between a client and the server is an authenticated one and nobody tries to intrude in that. So this was all about today's session, and you have seen that how with the help of a simple code in JavaScript, you can validate your form or you can validate any field that you want to. Now this will definitely help you authenticate your user while you are working on any website or web page. So this was all about today's session. I hope you enjoyed it. Now if you want to know more about JavaScript, you can go back and check out our videos on what is JavaScript and the JavaScript tutorial. Also, if you have any doubts, do let us know in the comment section below. We will get back to you as soon as possible. Till then, thank you and happy learning.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!